You're here, are you?
You're early.
No, I'm not.
Well, we usually get back much later than this when I come with you to see the kids.
What time is it? Well, you see, you have to look at your watch. You don't know what time it is. I get home to an empty house. There's not a note even. I've been tearing around like a blue-arsed fly. I've been to Max's, Henry's, now here.
Why?
Why? I was worried, for God's sake.
I meant, why didn't you telephone?
Ah, well, there was no reply at the others and this was engaged. What are you doing here anyway? You could have left a note.
She's here because she brought me home in the first place. And in the second place, there was nobody here at Max's or our Henry's, which might account for you getting no reply. And in the third place, we've had a catastrophe.
Gran means a catastrophe.
That's what I said. Oh, and while we're on the subject, I don't allow language. There's a punishment for language in this house.
I'm sorry. But I was worried. What's the trouble anyway?
Young guy's run away from school again. Sarah's just gone there with Max, and he says he won't be back tomorrow. And we can't get hold of Dad because we don't know where he is.
Well, I've just been into Ruth's, and she can't get hold of her Dad. But she says she'll keep on trying.
What's Jim Turner got to do with it?
Well, it seems they might have gone fishing to the same place.
Yes, please. Your father's there. He's with Dad. But she thinks they're still out.
Plot thickens.
It's Jesse Armstrong from the Black Lion.
And thickens even more.
Suppose I shouldn't have told you that.
I think at his age he's old enough to look after himself. In fact, it's his age that will look after him.
You hope. Where did you find Sarah?
She was coming from the direction of the cottage. Max told me he thinks she keeps a bottle there. I think it's a lover.
Yes? Oh, yes, please. Fine. Right, well, they're still out, but you give them a message. Look, I said one step at a time.
That was at least 4 hours ago. I'm not a tortoise.
All right, you've proved your point. You're not a tortoise. Ross, we've a lodger. He could come strolling in here any minute.
Damn the lodger!
One step at a time, right?
I don't think I like your having a lodger.
Oh, he's a bore. He's a walking encyclopedia on politics. Les calls him that. That's a compliment coming from Les. You think I'm a pampered woman, don't you? You know what's the worst thing in life? It's when you scream and nobody comes.
Get him out!
Quick!
I thought we'd never find a stopping place.
I did. The cemetery.
You like your fish and chips cold, don't you?
They'll not be cold. They were straight from the fat.
I'll let chap beside me go first. Get the last of the cold ones from the warmer.
He'll learn.
Sun's gone in. It's not so damn warm, is it? Hey, can't we eat them in the car?
Nay, Jean plays merry ale if she smells fish and chips. And she's...
Takes longer than you think, doesn't it? Weeks after they've gone, you find yourself talking to them.
Aye, you do.
Where are we?
I just stopped to look at the map. We should have stuck to the usual way. You damn Sunday drivers.
We're all allowed to kick over the traces once. It's a quotation.
What generous creature said that?
My husband.
If I hadn't known that you followed me down here to chat up Jesse Armstrong, I'd think that you were after sending me out.
Uh-huh.
You asked me if the militants had a plant in the works. I told you what I thought. But there's nothing I couldn't have said to anybody.
I shouldn't have asked, you mean? God, you don't like unofficial strikes any more than I do, Jim.
Well, happen the first thing I'd better do is to get it made official, then.
Oh, well, they've gone back.
Oh. We could have stopped on fishing.
Yeah.
You might have got some at court worth keeping.
No, I gotta go back anyway. That grandson of mine's run away from school again.
Well, they should have sent him to Ledston Comprehensive. He'd have had less fire to run.
No, it's not a good school. I'm not against the system as such. I'm against some of the results.
Hmm. Ruth would agree with you there. And she'd know better than you since she teaches it.
She's a grand lass, you know, Ruth. She's got her head screwed on. I used to hope that she and our Ross, you know, would make a go of it that time back, but what went wrong, do you reckon?
You can read a woman's mind, can you? I bloody well can't.
You'd not have objected, then? What's the joke?
Ah, used to be t'other road round, didn't they? Objections to them that wanted to wed outside their class.
There's a lot of things t'other road round since you and I were fancy free.
Are we going in or aren't we? I can't say the prospect excites me.
You've answered your own question then, haven't you?
No, I'm willing if you're hungry.
No, I don't fancy the place.
You said you were hungry.
Just wanted an excuse to stop. I felt tired. So...
Why not say so then? It's not a crime.
It is when you're driving.
Let me drive.
You had 4 scotches in the hour before we left home.
Counting, were you? I'm sorry. For blasting off at home.
It felt justified, actually. After all, I did tell him not to come home if he ran away again. I didn't mean it, of course. I just wanted him to know how strongly I felt about his not having the guts to stick it out.
Don't you think it takes guts to do what he's doing, to defy you?
Perhaps.
There might be something else behind all this than just not liking it. Have you thought of that?
What other reason could there be?
Oh, how should I know?
He talks to you.
Does he respect me, though?
Why shouldn't he?
You're not an easy man to fight, Max.
You think you have to fight me to have his respect?
Yes, when it's in his interest that I should fight you, try to convince you that you're wrong.
The schools back home are hopeless compared to where he is now. You know that. It's a fact. You'll be fighting that fact, not me.
He's unhappy. Sometimes I feel ashamed we brought him into the world.
Oh. I'm afraid I don't share the popular guilt, not in that way. Self-abasement of bringing life into a god-awful world. It's just a cover for inadequacy, a kind of running away.
Oh, Dippam, you...
Where are we staying?
Morrit Arms, as usual. Oh, it's a wasted journey. The formality of doing what the school expects of you so they won't be offended and refuse to take him back. Wherever he is, it won't be there.
I don't like to think of him alone out there. The dark.
Gran used to say there's nothing in the dark to make a child afraid.
It wasn't that kind of dark I was thinking of.
Didn't realise anyone else was up. I came for a glass of water.
Well, I'm making some tea if you'd like some. Oh. Thought you were having an early night.
Optimism. I'm an insomniac, you see. Well, to some extent. I sleep 5 hours or so at the most these days.
Some nights I sleep like a top, and others hardly at all.
Well, at least we don't keep anyone else awake.
Anyone else?
Sleeping alone.
Uh-huh. Used to keep your wife awake, did you?
No, I slept reasonably well in those days, living what they call a normal life. Father isn't back.
No, not yet. Well, you'll be able to start at the works now the strike's over, in the morning, I mean.
I'll be there to sign on. But nothing for the drivers till they get production going again.
And what's it achieved, eh?
Nothing, in my opinion.
I thought you would have been a stout supporter of the strike weapon.
Well, I am, of course. But not when it damages a class it's supposed to defend with nothing for the pain. I like us to win our battles, not lose them.
Don't we all suffer the consequences these days?
You always did.
And don't you think people have had enough of it?
I think people have had enough of quite a lot of things. Exploitation. Bad management, bad government.
No, we haven't had a taste of your kind of government yet, have we? Dictatorship of the proletariat. Once we did get a taste, that would be it, wouldn't it? Like it or lump it. You wouldn't let us vote you out.
The British Road to Socialism says we will.
What's that?
A declaration of policy the party's working on. The hardliners don't want to accept it, but they're in a minority, it seems.
They want the workers to seize power for good, do they?
Aye.
Well, they're honest men, then.
And the rest of us?
Vote catchers. We'd hardly be likely to vote you in if we didn't have the option of kicking you out again. Would we get that option once you got in? Like hell we would.
You're a cynic.
I'm a realist.
Oh, that's been near enough.
I thought it might be.
Union elections coming up soon.
Will you be standing again?
You're hoping so, aren't you? You could find yourself sitting across the table from some right hard case if I don't.
Except it might not be me.
Tempted to let go, are you?
Well, aren't you?
Oh, my God, I am.
Yeah, why don't you, Jim?
Well... I'd feel sorry for you, for what I'd let you in for.
Oh, pull the other one, it's got bells on it.
Well, what about you? Why don't you jack it in? You could live like a king for a century while you got stacked away.
Is that what you think?
You'll have been a damn bad manager if you've not.
What would I do, apart from a bit of fishing? I saved it to pass it on, to make it up to them for what I couldn't give them that was worth more than brass and time.
Fear of idleness, is that what's stopping
you? Oh, that amongst other things.
What other things?
I sold a house some 30-odd years ago when we moved here. It was a happy house. It was full of life until the kids started going to school. Had a lot done to it, that house. We got it just as we wanted it. It wanted nothing doing to it when we left, but the people that took over let it go. They didn't care. paint peeled off the garden went to ruins. I used to get a pain when I drove past it. Yeah, it's been empty for the past 2 years. They let it run down to the estate when nobody wanted to buy it. I don't want to drive past the works 10 years from now and feel the same pain.
You reckon you'll last another 10 years, Lee?
Well, you know what I mean, although you make light of it. You've put as much into Ledston cement as I have in your own way.
What makes us think that we're better than them coming after us? Well, I like to think otherwise. They're too fond of pulling down these days. Don't even make good use of their scrap nowadays. Waste not, want not.
They know. Now they do. Maybe it's not too late.
And we're on the way to being back in fashion, lad.
We are.
Where is this cottage?
Other side of the woods where I went walking today. Belongs to some people called Brassington. She was there, the woman. Let me look around. Someone that gave me a lift the day I came here.
What kind of a car?
Capri Gear. I fixed her exhaust.
Oh. Well, that would be Sarah Brassington, wife of one of the directors where you're going to work. She's one of your idle rich. And she's a nice woman.
Did I say she wasn't?
Look, there are all kinds of poverty, you know. Some women get a very raw deal in marriage. That's a kind of poverty.
I wouldn't deny it.
Oh, your voice had an edge to it when you mentioned her car. Why do you envy it? It's probably all she's got.
You're making unfair assumptions about me.
Well, you're above envy and prejudice, are you?
No.
I'd take that cottage if I were you.
Nobody to debate with in the late hours.
You'd soon get frustrated with that.
Frustrated?
I mean, I'm not open to conversion. Not a chance. Well, I think I'll go to bed.
I'll clear these.
But what are you doing back? Jessie phoned. She said you wouldn't be back until the morning.
I decided to take a lift. Here, you better put these in the fridge.
Oh, the catch.
Grilled trout tomorrow, if you fancy it.
Ian has the chance of a cottage, by the way.
Cottage, eh?
I'll be seeing about it tomorrow.
Well, there'll be no work for the drivers till they get the plant working again. You'll happen to need more than a cottage. You'll happen to need a job as well. Customers like to go elsewhere in our business when they don't get what they want on time. They need to know they don't have to keep their own customers waiting. I'm expecting talk of redundancies when I meet the management tomorrow.
I'm surprised to hear a socialist excusing redundancies.
I'm not seeking to excuse them. I'm seeking to excuse what brought them about to no purpose.
I'd have gone past and on home, except that I saw a light on. You don't want to keep her up to this hour at her age.
It was me kept him up. Not till the road round.
Tell her something she doesn't want to know, and she likes it being as deaf as a post. Where's your car?
Round the back. I'm staying here.
What's wrong with home?
It was empty.
It's never empty to me.
I can't live with a ghost.
Well, you better get used to it, lad. You meet a better class of people. Where's Max and Sarah?
Gone to the school.
He'll not go back there, Guy. He's left it to come home.
The school thing not. He took off yesterday as well, but he was found. When they found him, he said he wasn't going home.
Well, where then?
That's why they've gone to the school, to see what ideas they have.
He seemed settled enough in his mind when I took him back, though one of the masters I spoke to didn't rule out the chance that he might do it again. Where's Max and Sarah staying?
The usual place, the Morrit Arms, I think it's called.
I know the Morrit. The master I spoke to said he'd telephone me if it happened again. I expect he's been ringing an empty house. I'll phone him first thing in the morning. It's too late now. What's happening at the works, do you know?
Neil's been there since they took the pickets off. I asked to help, but he seems to want to cope with it himself.
I would, with Max being away. Your brother's not the only one who'd like to show what he's made of. Parent company board meeting tomorrow. I suppose Bill Summers will be phoning you with the news when it's over.
What news?
All the news that he wants you to tell me. Oh, don't worry, I won't embarrass you. I know how things are done. I can wait.
You make it sound like a plot.
Beginning to feel like a villain?
No.
You've seen Max today, of course.
I've seen him, yes. Ah. I took Gran and Ruth up to lunch there. Ah. Dot came.
Oh, that must have been fun for you.
She doesn't irritate me like she used to. I feel rather sorry for her, as a matter of fact.
There's nothing wrong between her and Neil, is there?
Well, not that I know of. Nothing serious, anyway.
Oh, she wouldn't tell me if there was. And I can't bring myself to ask her questions, Dot, that, you know, that I'd ask you lads. I used to leave it to her mother. I used to leave a lot of things to your mother. I suppose I ought to try and take her place with Dot, but I don't seem able.
I'll get my bag and come with you.
I'm not feared of ghosts, you know.
I'll come anyway.
Coming with you, is he?
So he says. You want him to stop?
Yeah, I'm used to being on my own.
No, you're not. You just don't like being dependent. It's not even that. It's admitting to dependence you don't like. I've asked you to come and stop with me. Well, if you won't, you won't.
I'll come if ever you need me.
Aye, and bring your own towels and linen, I suppose. You're all give and no take. You're an awkward woman, Mother.
You think you know all about me, don't you?
Your hair's getting thin. I can remember it down to your waist. I want to do things for you, and you won't let me.
I'll have all I need. Do you want me to make a need where there isn't one just to please you? Is that what you want? You daft lad. Daft lad.
It was a damn waste of time.
I suppose we had to come.
Formalities. At a time like this, they don't know any more than we do.
I got the impression they're prepared to take him back anyway, if that's what you want.
Did you? I didn't care to ask in the circumstances. He's probably at home now, having realised there's nowhere else for him to go to.
You think so?
Boys at Grand's being spoiled. That restaurant we stopped at last night. The music, the racket. God knows what it does to their brains, never mind their hearing. Do you understand his generation?
I don't think Guy necessarily belongs to that generation. I think he's somewhere on the dividing line between that and the next.
Whatever that might be.
Whatever that might be.
Mr. Rochester!
Is that the lot?
I think so, Mr. Brassington.
You better find out. I need to know.
Hello, Mr. Ross.
Hello. If you're up to your neck in it, tell me and I'll go.
There's a chap out there who's parked the work sweep in front of my car and gone off. And it's not even lunchtime.
He's probably on a shift.
I'll shift him.
Now, Dad, temper brings out the worst in all of us. I asked you to wake me before you left home.
You don't have to get up early to impress me. This board meeting in London, what time is it?
Usual time, I suppose. About now.
And who's going to talk to me afterwards? You or Mr. Summers? Oh, we've been pussyfooting around this since your mother's death. I suppose I put their plans back a bit. They'd want to wait a week or two, a decent interval, before dropping the hard word. They may be as hard as marble, but they don't like to be thought of as such. It's bad for their image, and images count these days. Acting lessons will soon be part of management curriculum, mark my words. So who's going to break the bad news to me, Ross?
You're making all sorts of assumptions, Dad.
In the face of your bloody silence, what option have I got to do but make assumptions?
If it had been anything I disagreed with, I'd have talked to you before now, and to hell with Summers and the London office.
I'm going to use you to soften the blow, is he?
I promised someone else I'd wait until they're here before I told you.
Max.
There's nothing to tell until the board meeting's over anyway.
I see.
You don't, actually.
I see enough. Enough to blow the roof already. If it wasn't for one thing, I want things to be right between you and me.
You think I don't want that, too?
You see this pile here?
These are orders that we should have been delivering today if we didn't have a strike on. Now, I shall have to call on all the goodwill that's owing to me to get this business back again. I shall personally have to guarantee deliveries in future. No one else in the company can do it. I do it through trust, their trust, that I will hold to what I say. My trust in Jim Turner to take care that it doesn't happen again, and his trust in me to see that I don't give the men any reasonable cause to strike.
You don't have to justify your existence to me, Dad.
Max couldn't handle it.
I'm asking you to trust me.
Oh, then you're with me.
I'm with you, yes.
Look, the board might not be. No, that's not fair. I'm playing guessing games again, and you ask me to trust. Very well, I shall trust. Now, tell you one thing, Ross, if you need telling. I only trust once.
Dan, we're on our way back.
Mrs. Brassington.
Yes?
My name's Evans. I'm Guy's housemaster. I missed you at the school. I had a class. Excuse me, I'm a bit out of condition, I'm afraid.
This is it?
Yes, I know.
You know it?
We used to come here years ago.
We?
Oh, I wasn't always footloose and fancy-free.
You've not been married, though.
Well, marriage of minds or whatever.
So that's why you wanted to come.
Nostalgia.
It's about 40 miles from here on the Stoneleigh Road.
Why did the head say nothing about this?
It's a hunch of my own. I could be quite wrong.
Why couldn't you have said something earlier?
I tried to ring his grandfather yesterday. I met him when he brought Guy back. He seemed to be the type who'd understand. If you hadn't come today, I'd have told the head, of course.
We're going to look damn stupid if you're wrong, aren't we? Descending on complete strangers with a story like this.
Sad.
Not lived up to the dream.
Well, it's uncared for.
Oh, you're looking at it from a woman's point of view.
Well, you're not thinking of taking it, are you?
Why not?
Look, I know we're not used to lodgers. Maybe we haven't treated you as well as we should.
It's not that at all.
What is it, then?
Well, your boyfriend isn't going to like me being at your place, is he?
Boyfriend? Well, for God's sake. Who says I've got a boyfriend, anyway?
Well, he went out with someone the other night.
That's got nothing to do with it. You can do better than this.
It'll suit me.
Determined to leave us, are you?
I think it's better I did.
I don't mind banging away at the old politics, you know. I'm quite used to that with Dad.
There are other reasons, too.
Well, it's your life.
Aye.
Well, I've got to get back to school. Are you coming?
Oh, no, I'll hang on a few minutes. Size the place up.
Right. Well, I'll see you later.
No point in us talking today, Jim. I mean, Max isn't here, and I don't take Neil away from his work.
My lot are not too keen to leave off work. Guilty consciences about not turning up at that meeting, I dare say.
First unofficial strike.
All right.
Since they're out and back, might as well not have bothered. What brought them back, Jim?
Thought better of it.
No pressure from above.
The union made it plain from the start we were against it.
I wasn't talking about the union.
Oh. Still seeing reds under the bed, Henry.
I can smell something under the bed, and so can you, though you won't say nothing.
You can smell it as well as I can. Better happen.
You reckon?
What you were saying last night about standing again in the union election, you meant it, did you?
Aye, I did. Worse luck.
Who is it could stand against you?
There's our Les.
Would he stand?
He might, if I stood down.
Could he beat you if he did?
Well, he might, given the fact that the incomers vote for him.
You're Les. He's not stupid.
You'd not want him across the table from you.
What's his shortcoming?
Blood pressure. Rushes of blood to the head. He takes the opposite line from me on principle. If I want to reason, it's weakness, yielding to the capitalist yoke. What's more, he's to prove himself. You make your name by rant, not reason these days.
A Marxist, is he?
Well, his leanings in that direction, so have a lot of his generation. Can you blame him? What have the moderates like me got to show?
Well, a social revolution with the roof still over our head.
He takes no account of that, doesn't Les? He believes in Aladdin's lamp. Why are you asking me all this?
I can't say right now.
Not taking me into your confidence?
I can't say because I don't know. You're not the only person that doesn't get taken into other people's company.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll come back later.
And Jim was just going.
Black Lion tonight.
I could be.
Andal's behind the bar, standing in. You'll enjoy a chat with Andal.
How's everything?
Oh, not bad, considering.
Oh, there's a driver out there I wanted to see to before he kills one of his mates. A chap on the works sweeper. Probably found he's been skiving as well.
Oh?
Yeah, get him off that sweeper. I spoke to Max about him, but nothing's been done. Find him something useful to do, like work. And if there's any trouble, get rid.
Ruth said I might find you here.
I fell asleep. I thought she was going to the school.
She was. I met her on the way. You're taking it, she says.
Eh, yeah, well.
And how much do the robbing bastards want for it, eh?
£8 a week.
Property. Still, you can go to the rent officer once you're settled in.
It'd be £8 a week if the state owned it. Anything less wouldn't be economically viable.
You're a funny sort of bloke, aren't you? Talk like a boss sometimes.
You don't win arguments by blinding yourself to facts. You've got to see things as they are before you change them.
Reg thought we might have a drink tonight. Thought he's standing against Dad at the union elections again when they come. Not a cat in hell's chance.
Why?
Oh, a lot of the blokes don't take to him.
Sounds like a walking textbook on Marxism. That's why one left-wing cliche after another.
Oh, I've often thought that myself. It's funny to hear you saying it.
Don't tell me I'm a funny sort of bloke again. You'll have me at the psychiatrist. You'd stand a better chance than Reg, I should think.
Well, put up against Dad.
Don't you think that in the long run he might respect you for it?
Reg thinks you can help him. Well, he took your advice over the strike, told the lads they'd made their point. God, oh, they'd have not stopped out long anyway. I reckon you got him off the hook there.
If the men don't teach him, he's going to damage the cause by standing.
Yeah, well, you can hardly tell him that, though, can you?
He must know your chances are better. He'd be put himself before party if he refused to stand down for you.
I'm not in his party.
Neither am I. I'm in the Labour Party, as you are.
I wouldn't have thought Labour had much to offer you.
It doesn't, as it stands. I'm in it to change it.
Who for?
For what I believe in.
I'm closer to Reg than most of the others round here, but I'd not cross, nor stand to someone I'm not.
You think that's me, do you?
You'd not tell me if it was, would you?
Well, think it over anyway. For the sake of what you believe.
And what about you?
Me? I've not been to the place 5 minutes. You can't swing a meeting like Reg, do you? You can't swing a vote as easily.
Except through somebody like me, I mean.
Who told you this?
A master at the school.
He suggested that your boy might be here.
He thought he might head in this direction. Seems a bit of a long shot. He thought so himself.
Well, we've certainly seen no sign of him.
You don't rule it out, though.
No, of course not. And it's very worrying for you. You were perfectly right to come. I'd have done the same myself.
You don't sound very surprised.
That Jean and your son had some sort of relationship at the school, you mean? No, I'm not, as a matter of fact. These things happen, don't they?
But you didn't know. I mean, she didn't tell you.
No, but did children ever tell their parents these things? I know I never did. Things are different nowadays. I've never, at least I hope I haven't ever, given her the impression that she couldn't talk to me about something like this.
Her mother?
No, Madge certainly doesn't know. Jean's been, well, a bit different since we took her away from school at the end of last term. We put it down to the fact that she was missing her friends. It doesn't fit, you see. That's why what you've just said doesn't altogether surprise me.
Could we talk to her?
Well, I don't know where she is. With friends somewhere in the village, I suppose, but I couldn't say who. Now, her mother will know. She's gone down to the shop in the car, but she'll be back shortly. Cigarette?
No.
I shouldn't with this damn cold. Wish I could pack it up altogether, but the tensions of living these days. You're from Ledston, you say?
Yes. The plant was closed until today for a strike. I've had to leave my father to get things going again while I sort this lot out. Could I use your phone? I'll transfer the change, of course.
Yes, it's in the hall on a packing case by the door. The code book's underneath if you want it.
Thank you.
Sorry about all this damn mess.
You're moving?
Yes. Abroad. Canada.
Oh?
You're thinking what I'm thinking, aren't you?
Young love.
Yes, we forget, don't we? We grow older, we forget.
Now you're going to Canada. There's a prospect of thousands of miles between them.
Yes.
I was wondering why he came home the first time he ran away from school instead of doing what he's doing now, assuming that this is true, of course. Perhaps he wanted to tell us something then.
He said nothing?
My mother-in-law died that day. We were listening even less than usual.
I think it probably is true, you know, all this.
Yes, so do I. Max is hoping that it isn't, I'm sure.
They're very young, 16. Your boy is 16, is he?
Guy, yes, he is.
Yes, Jean's 16. Your husband isn't going to like the idea, you think?
No.
No, my wife's not going to be too keen either. Jean's an only child.
We're going to have to be very careful, aren't we?
I've got £8 and only 50p left. Bus back to town will be 50p. Well, just over.
Is that your purse?
It's a little Welsh purse. My gran gave it to me. Well, she's my great-gran, really. You'd like my gran.
Have you decided yet?
Well, I'll stay at the same place tonight. Think things over. Won't have anything much left then. Everything's so expensive. I used to think money was rubbish.
So did I.
Don't know anything. That's the trouble.
About what?
Well, what happens to kids who leave school at our age?
They're unemployed mostly, aren't they?
Yes, I know, but they get money while they're looking for work. I mean, I don't know how much or where they get it or anything. Don't equip us for life at that place.
Please, teacher, where to get the money?
I saw a place called the Citizens Advice Bureau in the town this morning. I felt like walking in there and saying, "Hi, I'm a citizen and I'd like some advice, man."
Suppose it's a woman.
Well, then I'd say, give us some money, honey. Going away from me to Canada.
I'm not gone yet.
But you will go. You know you will. You don't feel the same about it as I do.
Yes, I do.
Not the same.
Yes, I do. It's just too much for us, isn't it?
Too much.
Too much.
We're just kids to them. Give me the money, honey!
Your mother will be feeling awful about you.
Yes, I know. I would have gone home and told her, but Dad would be there. Can't believe I've actually run away again in a way, you know. It's like walking in a cloud on Ledston Tops.
Where
I live when they let me go home.
I'll never see where you live.
You've accepted it, you see.
What?
You've accepted it. Going to Canada, you've accepted it. Oh, you'll remember me for a day or two, and then you'll forget. A new life. Sunset over the Rockies. You'll get a Canadian accent and you'll marry a lumberjack. There's nothing we can do about it, is there?
You're letting it get you down.
On your feet, Brassington.
They'll let you come with us when they know what we've done.
Yes, forgotten about that. We've got that to cope with yet. So we're too young. We are in a way, I suppose. When we're old enough to cope, we'll be just like them, plodding on in the general direction of nowhere.
Mr. Rankert?
Yeah?
Who put you to work on the sweeper?
Mr. Brassington.
What, Mr. Max himself?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what Bramker said. Do you know Mr. Max?
I work for him, don't I? I mean, he's one of the bosses, isn't he?
No, I mean, apart from that.
I do as I'm told, that's all.
Your timekeeping's a bit erratic, isn't it?
I do as I'm told.
I hear the sweeper was left here for 3 hours this afternoon after Bramcott told you to sweep the yard. Now, I don't think Mr. Max would like that.
You'd better see him, then. I just do as I'm told.
I've told you I can't have lunch with you because I've got to get Dad's as well as my own. And I've less than an hour to do it in.
He can go to the chippy, can't he? Mm.
Well, you tell him that. He'll be here in a minute. I see. All highly organised and highly efficient. Not like British industry. You could use a few housewives there.
That's how you see yourself, is it? Housewife?
Mm-hmm. A leading question on a Monday morning with a great wet cloud over Ledston Tops.
Whose side is he on?
Side? What side? Who?
Jim. Whose side is he on? Yours or mine?
Side? He's got to take sides, has he? Oh. It's a war, is it?
Of course it's a war.
You remember getting lost with me once on Ledston Tops?
Yes.
We were 17.
That was the day, wasn't it?
The day? Is that how you remember it? The day?
Well, don't you? I thought all women were supposed to.
What?
Remember it to the exclusion of all else.
Remember what?
The first time.
Well, men obviously do. How do you know it was the first time, anyway?
Oh, come off it. I might have been young and untutored, but not that young. Anyway, it's instinctive, deep in the human psyche.
Well, it's certainly deep in yours. Well, now I definitely know what the attraction is. It's nostalgia.
Maybe.
You admit it?
Possibly. Depends how you define nostalgia. Well, come on, teacher, dictionary definition.
You already know it, of course.
I admit having looked it up in the fairly recent past.
Right, come on then.
From the Greek, nostos, return home. Algos, pain. Usually only a transient emotional manifestation.
Well, there you are, you see. You bear with it, it'll pass.
Is that what you want?
Ross, it is a Monday, and there is a great wet cloud over Ledston Tops.
I asked an honest question.
Which deserves an honest answer, which, at the moment, I can't give.
I want some roots in life.
There's another definition to nostalgia which you haven't quoted. It's often based on emotional insecurity. You know, looking back to the safe years.
You've got your analysis wrong. I wasn't looking back to that. I was looking back to a day when I got lost on Ledston Tops.
To be honest, I remember that day very clearly. It's part of what I am, what made me. I know you better than you know yourself, possibly. Give it time, don't rush it. You're like an impatient adolescent. You can't wait to find out what it's all about after all the talk and so on. And it never is it? Not quite. Even the best times never quite lives up to the dream.
That lived up to the dream.
One step at a time, please.
Time's at a premium these days.
Well, you're going to be here, aren't you? I mean, you're coming back here to work, to live.
I think so, yes. I'm almost certain. Pending a phone call in a couple of hours' time.
Well, then there is time, isn't there?
I passed this chap on his way to the pub to eat. Now, is he lodging with us or isn't he?
Well, hasn't he told you?
He's told me he's taken a cottage, aye, but he's not there yet, is he?
It's all under control.
Oh, it's under control. Oh, this is Ross Brassington, by the way, Ian McKellar. He's come for a driver, as we used to say.
I'll go and wash it. There's none too clean at the cottage.
All under control. All under control. You're eating here as well, are you?
I'd be the last straw, I think.
It's a good man as knows when to go.
For Sam. Mr. Summers rang from London for Mr. Ross. Will he be back?
Mr. Ross? Yes, I think so. I'll see he gets the message.
Thank you.